Well, this is as good a place as any to start. Basically, these hives were all new last year that I, those two over there, and this one and these, they're all newish with relatively young queens, and they're the ones that survived. There's a couple in there else that did, but there's a lot of deadness going on too. 11 is all I got here in this yard. So with the three at home, that makes 14, which isn't really bad. That's a great place to start this season. It's happened to me where I had only 12 or 11 or 10. So it ain't the end of the world. This is how it begins. I need to get suited up and go get some fuel for the smoker, and then I'll start this back up again. Okay, I've been looking these over while I'm standing here putting my gear on. The one that looks like it's really needing my attention the most is that one. So let's go do it. See what we got. You never know, you just have to look. You can't tell by the traffic at the door, but we all try. But really, I don't think that is the greatest way of checking. This one is tall over on the corner, looks like it's pretty busy. It's kind of oversized. I got too busy last fall and I just took off, and that one was the one that got left with a lot of honey on there. And it's been able to use it and turn it into probably a bunch of bees. And I'll probably save that one for a while. Maybe it'll swarm. I could use a swarm on a hive that is swarming right now, actually. It wouldn't hurt. But it's not like I want it either. Going from the numbers I had down to 11 here, it is, kind of bad, but again, it's happened before. I could fix it. You kind of need to keep new queen bees cycling through the yard, and I didn't do much of that last year. I'm not paying the price this spring. I should probably move this camera a little closer to the one I'm going to work on. And maybe get it where the sun is behind it. I've got my sunglasses on like a fool. I gotta get them off so I can see better. The new stuff, you just kind of reach up in here. It's not that big of a deal. Pull your glasses off. Here, right in front of the hive, which is kind of a no-no. Let's dig in. I'm a little excited. Let's see. Just a little bit of smoke. Top looks good. I don't see a lot of hive beetles or anything. I think I'll separate the boxes. That way I can search this top one and know for sure that the queen's not in it. And then make decisions. Feels like the frames are stuck together. have this apart since last year. Stretch. That's drone larvae. Birds will eat it. The bees will eat it, use it too. Sap looks pretty strong. It's not like super aggressive. In general, that's how it is on there. That's where the bees ain't just plain pissed off. Gentle, and you can handle them and not get them all filled up. I see cells down there that are capped. So it's quite possible that the queen might be in the bottom. Let's search through the top anyway. Got this top sitting on the ground out in front. This is this pack of bees. So you gotta start on the edge. Push everything over to one side. You gain about a quarter inch. Really, a lot of space in here. Not easy to slip this frame out. Gotta crush it. This is just a shallow box. And that's all nectar and honey. Some pollen too. It's all resources there. Can't put the shady side to put these on. On the bottom of it. They're not active. Not active. Three different size boxes, deep, medium, and shallow. And this is a shallow. It's meant for making comb honey. But I had so many of them, I started using them just for whatever. I'm pretty sure the queen here is unmarked, so I have to look hard. Crap. drag us slow aside or make them mad. That's why they were stuck together, because they were kind of honeycombed together. I don't see a queen. These bees are all like tiny, young nurse bees, pretty much. Size on the build up, just like all the others I've been looking at. Starting to look like older larvae. Everything's laid, so I don't think the queen's gonna be here. This is cap rood. It's just kind of how I want it. On both sides. So later when I put the clean excluder on, that I'm going to have to go get, then I can just add another super on top like I've been doing them other hives, and this will be ready to go. So far I'm not seeing any queen bee. It doesn't mean it doesn't have one, it just means it's not here. Another one, same kind of deal. I'm not seeing any eggs anywhere though, so the queen has gone down to the bottom, I think. But I've got four more frames to go, and I'm just not seeing a queen or a whole lot of evidence. Which usually means she's in a different part of the hive. Kind of play detective as you go here. Where she's been a while ago. That is pretty. It's kind of easy school. Looks like we're running out of room. We start to get pollen and nectar. here's some interesting information that you might need to see to believe. See the purple eyes? They turn black right before they come out. Those cells I destroyed were drones that were about 2 or 3 days from emerging. Big deal.
But that's going on at the bottom of the frame. There's a bunch of drones. Tell by the buzz on this eye that they are not mad. You're just gently buzzing. Not roaring. When they start roaring, that's not good. Think times you might want to just get the bees off out of your way so you can work. You don't want to do a whole lot of shaking, that stirs them up. Sure, the queen's not in this box, but I'm gonna keep looking. Sometimes they just run. They're pretty good at keeping our side if they want to. That's what's tiring me out. I probably only need one hive today. This is all nectar. There's no reason for the queen to be on this thing. So you can tell which queen, which box the queen is just by listening. Man, my beak hands are covered in this sticky shit. It's like stuff all on the sticker. That one is the quiet one. This was buzzing a little. So I bet that she in here. Let's take a look. You might get lucky and find her real quick. But I think this is done pretty much. This is on nectar and pollen and bees. The other side, it's the same thing, left to right, all in bees, no eggs, no food. Man, I wish it wasn't so stupid. has a milk breed in there. That's like eggs that are just hot. The queen is here, but a few days ago. This weird is on the other side, it's all pollen, nowhere we need to lay eggs. But there's a little patch.
Man, this beehive is about to explode and have a lot of bees. There's the queen right there by my thumb. She's unmarked. She's looking at herself. Right there's the queen. Right in the corner. She's not running or trying to hide or anything. She's looking for places to lay eggs is what she's doing. I'm putting this side back together. I found the queen right there. Easy peasy. She's a nice looking queen too. I should mark her with last year's color. I'm not set up for it today. Let's just put this side back together. And set it up for honey. Because this is in great shape. I'm going to go home and have a cool drink. Maybe come back and do one more today. I can't do this like it's my full-time job. I'm old and retired. Hot. I'm going to run and go get an excluder. I guess I'll just let the camera run. It's right over there. Look for queen cells. I got nothing. This is a great show. How do you get this sticky stuff off your gloves? You put them in the freezer. They'll get real cold and then slap them together and it cracks off like ice. Ends up on your smoker and everything. But things have been going my way on the last two hive inspections. This
one's gonna be a big one, I can tell. The smoke from these are up at the bottom. So I can set it down. Starting to get a little out of control. There's so damn many of them. And all the field bees are coming back to this. I'm gonna kill a couple bees. They ain't gonna let them. Until a minute ago, he turned on me. At a certain point, he said, fuck it, I hate these bitches. But then they really turned on me. They kind of wanted to resist that. Probably set another super on. This one already has honeycomb. We're gonna fill this up hasty quick. This whole box will just be honey.
old. I get tired easy. Well, that's how we roll here in the bee yard. I've got 10 more to go. Have a great day, everybody. God bless you. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.